In this video, I'm going to show you how to screen record with internal computer audio on a Mac. By the end of this video, you'll be able to screen record with a simple shortcut, and you'll even be able to include your webcam, microphone, and even your internal computer audio. Just make sure you watch to the very end so you don't miss anything. Let's go. All right, let's jump right in. First off, go to obsproject.com and download and install the free and open source OBS Studio. Once installed, open it up and you'll need to give OBS Studio permission to record on your Mac. So just go through each of these settings and grant permissions for OBS and then close and reopen OBS Studio and you're good to go. You can get to this dialog at any time from the OBS menu, review app permissions. Next, we're going to open settings and set things up. We'll be setting up output, audio, video, and hotkeys. So first, click output and make sure you set the recording path. I have mine set to desktop, and this is where it'll save all of your recordings on your computer, and it's nice to have that set up and know where it's putting the files. Next, set the recording quality to high quality and change the recording format to MP4. Why MP4? Well, it's the most universal video format and it's supported by just about everything. Here, if you have the option available, choose H.264, which is a universal format, but if you don't see this option, you can always choose this software option. For audio, here you can specify the microphone you'd like to use. I have a few microphones available for this computer, so I can tell it which one I want to use. And in hotkeys, I recommend setting up a shortcut to start recording and stop recording. You can make this anything you want, but I'll just use F10 for this. And now we are all set. Just click OK. Now from here, you'll want to add a new source to this empty scene that you start with. Click this little plus here under sources, and now you can choose what you want to actually capture. Click Mac OS Screen Capture and click OK. For method, you can choose whether to capture a whole display, specific window, or application. I'll choose display capture. And here you can choose which display you want to capture. So I'll choose one of my dual monitors and then click OK. Next, right-click the preview and click Resize Output Source Size and then click Yes. And now you should see everything on your screen in this little window if you didn't before. Now open up settings one more time, go to video this time, and here we can set the saved output video size. You can choose 1920 by 1080 for high definition or HD, or 3840 by 2160 for 4K if your monitor supports it. 1920 is perfectly fine for most people, but if you want 4K content, choose 3840, just know that the file size will be 4 times larger. I'll just go with 1920 for this tutorial, then click OK. From here, if you want to add a webcam, you can add another source by clicking plus under sources and then choose video capture device and click OK. Here you can choose a webcam. Mine's currently not active, but click OK and just imagine this is your live webcam and you can move and resize this wherever you want. I'll remove this for now though, but I just wanted to show you how to add a webcam if you wanted. Last thing, here you can see the audio levels coming in. You might want to slide your desktop audio down a bit if you're also recording your voice, so your voice isn't drowned out by the computer's audio. And just make sure your mic audio isn't cutting into this red here when you talk. If it exceeds 0 decibels, it'll start to clip and sound really bad. Now we can press start recording or hit F10 to start recording. And now we're recording. So I'll just pull up one of my videos to use as an example. I'll
share with you 10 of the absolute best free tools you can use to create videos for YouTube. Bye.
And now I'll hit F10 to stop recording. Now on the desktop, we can see here's our recorded video file. So let's just double click this and boom, there we go. Mission accomplished. Here's our screen recording with internal computer audio.
I'll share with you 10 of the absolute best free tools you can use to create videos for YouTube.
Now I know that was a lot, so here are the steps and you can just pause here if you need to. By the way, if you're getting value out of this video, hit like, subscribe, and tap the notification bell to get more valuable content like this. If this video helped, feel free to leave a comment below. Now, if you're on Mac OS 12 or older, then sadly, OBS Studio won't be able to screen record with your internal computer audio. But fortunately, there's still a way to do it. I have a separate video on this for older Macs, and you can watch that video right here. And since you've made it this far, if you want to learn how to make the best use of your menu bar on a Mac, then check out this video next. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.